Iran is the anchor of stability in an otherwise ocean of regional instabilities. The so-called Iranian threat, which has been employed as an excuse to justify a long catalog of crimes and catastrophic practices over the past 3 decades. Unjust sanctions, as manifestation of structural violence, are intrinsically inhumane and against peace. It is not the state and the political elite that are targeted, but rather it is the common people who are victimized by these sanctions. The human tragedy in Syria represents a painful example of catastrophic spread of violence and extremism in our region. We emphasized that there was no military solution to the Syrian crisis. Pursuit of expansionist strategies and objectives and attempts to change the regional balance through proxies cannot be camouflaged behind humanitarian rhetoric. Iran and other actors should pursue two common objectives: one, Iran's nuclear program, and for the matter, that of all other countries, must pursue exclusively peaceful purposes. This has been and will always be the objective of the Islamic Republic of Iran. The second objective, that is, acceptance of and respect for the implementation of the right to the enrichment inside Iran and enjoyment of other related nuclear rights, provides the only path toward achieving the first objective. Acceptance of the inalienable right of Iran constitutes the best and the easiest way of resolving this issue. In this context, the Islamic Republic of Iran is prepared to engage immediately in time-bound and result-oriented talks to build mutual confidence. Iran seeks constructive engagement with other countries based on mutual respect and common interests, and within the same framework, does not seek to increase tensions with the United States. I listened carefully to the statement made by President Obama today at the General Assembly. Commensurate with the political will of the leadership in the United States, and hoping that they will refrain from following the short-sighted interests of warmongering pressure groups, we can arrive at a framework to manage our differences. The human society should be elevated from the state of mere tolerance to that of collective collaboration.